learn about the off-grid lifestyle and to be inspired to live your dreams, click subscribe so you don't miss anything. Hit the bell notification. Okay, so I've showed you in the past my meat birds, but it's been a while since you've seen them probably. There they are. They're coming up on 5 weeks this Thursday. This is Tuesday, so they're almost 5 weeks old now. We'll start butchering them when they're 8 weeks old, the bigger ones. They'll be about 10 pounds by that time. Look at that. There's a butterfly on one of them. Usually the chickens will eat those. Wonder what the deal is. We got these guys, I think they were a day or two old. Must have been a day old. I think we got them on a Friday. They were born on Thursday. You'll see in here that I have this little domed building that I built. This is out of coroplast and some 2x4s. And I had hoped that they would use that more than they do, but they don't. A few of them will go in there occasionally, like you see here. But in general, they just stay out of it. And so then I have these little tents, canvas tents, that you buy for camping, yard sales, that kind of thing. This has worked out really well. Keeps a lot of shade in them, and it does seem to keep the wildlife out. The whole reason that I did it this way is so I can move it around easily. It was cheap and easy. These are called Cornish Cross. They're designed specifically for meat. These guys won't live very long, no matter how well you treat them, maybe a year. You give them 22% protein, and they grow really fast. Of course, you can give them 18%, and then they'll grow a little bit slower. But the whole key to this is trying to keep your cost down. A month and a half ago, you could buy a Tyson chicken at Save-A-Lot for 14 bucks. That was an 8-pound chicken. So these are gonna be about 10 pounds when they're fully grown in 8 weeks. And I will have spent about $8. If I was to raise 28 Tyson chicken, it would be $490, I think is what I came up with. I raise 28 of these guys and it's gonna be $169. So a significant difference. The problem is you can buy leg quarters for 60 cents a pound. So these guys are actually more expensive than the leg quarters at Save-A-Lot. The problem with Save-A-Lot is they're starting to sell out. So right now, this is still pretty cost effective. And my dad always says, this is health insurance right here because you're eating healthy. You know what you're putting in them. We know there's no chemicals or, you know, any bad stuff. We buy our feed. We know what we're buying. So these guys are 4 weeks old and up till now, we haven't lost any of the chickens. But this morning I got up and we didn't lose one. I ended up putting it out of its misery, unfortunately. When I got up this morning, I noticed there was a chicken that was missing a wing. Something had tore its wing off, at least a good portion of its wing. It was alive and it wasn't eating or drinking. It was trying to sleep, actually. So I took it out and I put it in one of these gray bins. Of course, it was upside right. Until Carolyn got up, she sleeps a little later than me. I gave him some food and water. But he didn't move around very much. And it was still kind of darkish when I was out here. When she got up, we came down and did a little bit of investigating. And what we saw was, we saw feathers. The chicken was still in the cage. So we have feathers outside the cage, but we have chickens inside the cage. Now, if a raccoon or a possum would have gotten in there, there wouldn't have been anything left. Most everything would have been destroyed. I mean, once a possum or raccoon gets in there, they just kill it all, everything. They just go after everything. But here we have just one chicken missing a wing. I got onto the trail cam and looked at the pictures on the trail cam. We have a trail cam right here. Up till now, all we've seen is raccoons down here. And here's some footage of that. But last night, we saw the possum somewhere right here. So to give you some perspective, I'll just turn you around real slow so you don't get dizzy. There's the chicken cage. There's the trail cam. You come right over there by that brick. There's the feathers. And right here, roughly, the possum is eating something. I'll show you that picture. So what we determine is the chickens won't sleep inside their coop here. I don't know why. I can't get them to go in there. I've put their food in there. I've done everything I can to get them to go in there, and they won't. They always sleep right here by the fence. Now you can see what I've done with the fence. I've got two layers of fencing material. I've got chicken wire, and then I got this 14 gauge. The reason I did the 14 gauge and the chicken wire was one, to keep the chickens from going through this. When they were smaller, they could go right through this 14 gauge, walk right through it. Then the 14 gauge I've wrapped around so nothing can dig up underneath it. I put bricks right here and nothing will dig in it. Usually what they'll do is they'll dig right here on the fence. They're not clever enough to get up underneath this like this. So you put some bricks on it and they won't go underneath it. So what Carol and I determined was that Possum was able to get his claw up under here, grab one of the feathers and pull it out. Because you can see the feathers are right here. So he pulled that wing out and got it pretty significantly. I don't want to be too disgusting, and I can't show you the pictures on YouTube, of course, so don't worry about that. But what he did was not only did he bite the chicken wing off, he then pulled and ripped the skin off the chicken also up underneath its belly. The chicken was pretty hurt. We thought about, should we go ahead and treat the chicken? But then we thought, no, that's going to run up a cost. So right now, that chicken has cost us $3.37. We have to add that $3.37 to the cost of these. That's going to raise our cost. If we're up to $169 on food costs, we've got to add another $3, $3.37. Obviously, everyone you lose, you're losing that much more money. So I need to make some changes, modifications to this. I mean, it still works, but we can't have the possum in there reaching in and grabbing them, and I can't get the chickens to sleep underneath their dome. So I've got this hardware cloth here. It's a metal mesh. And I use this on the chicken coop. So on the floor of the chicken coop, I've got this laid down. Got a little bit over 10 feet and I need 20 feet. So I'm gonna cut it in half. That'll give me just a little over 20 feet. And then I'm gonna put that at the bottom here so the possum and raccoon can't reach through. Okay, so now when the chickens decide to lay down here next to the fence, this will keep the possum from being able to reach in and grab them. Now all I'm gonna do is the same thing I've done before, and I'm gonna use zip ties to hold it in place. This is gonna be kind of challenging. Zip ties are easy to replace. They're cheap. And if I decide to change my mind later, I can just snip them off. All right, so I got it on. And so nothing should be able to get their fingers up underneath here very good to get anything. So I'll put some more bricks around here. I just wanted to leave the bricks off until you got to see it all. And then the door, I put blocks in front of the door so nothing can get underneath the door. Okay, so there's one more aspect to this. I am not just stopping there and saying, okay, let's lose another one. I really don't want to lose anymore. So I know that I have 4 raccoons and at least 1 possum. I've been thinking about doing this anyways, getting a live trap. This should hold a possum, raccoon, cat, groundhog. I know I got groundhogs around here, I've seen them. I'm going to set this right in front of the trail cam. And I'm going to set it down here where I know the possum comes up at. The raccoons don't usually come up this far. And if I get something, then you and I will get to take a trip out to the conservation area with whatever I catch, because I'm going to relocate it out to the conservation area. Okay, that wasn't too terribly bad. It's really easy to operate. Here you just pull the trap back. That lifts the door here. This little foot pedal right here triggers it. So that means you put your bait on the other side of this pad here. The animal walks in the door, steps on the pad, and he's trapped in there. I should be able to get a possum or a raccoon or something today. Then I'll also record it so we can see the event happen. I tried to do everything I could to make sure these chickens are absolutely protected. I know a lot of people would say, hey, you need a coop, but that's just going to be too expensive for meat birds. They're only going to live 8 weeks, and you're only going to do it once a year, maybe twice if you're lucky, but regardless, it just doesn't make financial sense to build a big coop for them. Secondly, you want to keep them cool, because these guys, are not very tolerant of temperature, cold temperature or hot temperature. So here we have this nice breeze. They can stay comfortable in the summertime. Probably why they're not going into the dome building. It might be too hot in there for them. Most anybody who raises meat birds puts them in a contraption like this. And I guess you're just going to have to learn from experience what's going to get them and what's not. I mean, I just never thought that a raccoon would reach in there, or a possum reach in there and grab a wing. It would never occur to me. So I lesson learned, and it was a $3 lesson is what it was, $3.37. Carolyn is a member of several meat bird groups on Facebook. And she every day is telling me different scenarios of things that, oh, people did this or did that. Most people have heat-related death. We haven't had any heat-related death, so we got that right. The coop is big enough that they're not getting so filthy from their own waste. We have a very large confinement, 100 square feet. I guess this is just one of those things you have to kind of learn your lesson on, and then next year you'll be better at it. I'm really fortunate that we've got 4 weeks through and we've only lost one. The average that Carolyn has come up with on the Facebook groups is about 3. We got 4 more weeks left. If we lose 2 more, then we'll be about average. I'm working very hard not to lose any more. I didn't want to lose any in the first place. I just keep looking at this as a dollars and cents thing, and it's going to be very tight margins to say that we should go to the store. Now, of course, the store keeps going up in price. Every time we go up, it goes up at like another 50 cents for 10 pounds. If it keeps going up, then we're going to be in good shape. So I hope I can inspire you to not get discouraged when you're living your dream. Thanks for watching.